Hey everyone, welcome to another Painting with Jay. As always, my name is Jay. Time to paint along. So grab a brush, grab some models, grab some paints, and have some fun. Let's get rid of the unpainted models of the world. Let's paint them up, make them look awesome. Together we can. So today I'm going to keep working on a Space Marine Librarian and my Captain for my Demi Company for Imperial Fists. Probably starting off with my Captain, but working on the side with my Librarian as well. And all will be good. I'll talk about my week. It's been interesting. Yeah. Let's say that. So, let's get started. Yes. Hey everyone! So, as you can see, I'm working on my Space Marine Captain right here. And my Librarian and Terminator armor. Here he goes! Today. It's gonna be a lot of fun. Let's see. Yeah, my goal is to finish up. At least maybe my Captain today. We'll see. I'll just get, start painting now. See how much we get done as always. That's the spirit of Painting with Jay. You know, just get as much done as you can in an hour. Ramble. Get work done. That's all it is. We paint as a group. Yes. Very deep words. So, right now I'm just going to start by painting up Lead Belcher. And getting the metallics done on this guy. Because, that's what I want to do. And then I'll cut in the metallics after the shading. So a little Lead Belcher goes a long way. Yeah, so it's been an interesting week. No, not terrible or anything, just interesting, expensive, and that's kind of life in general, as you know. Life gets expensive, right? And so I was riding around my motorcycle, went and saw a friend on Sunday, and I was on my way home. Now, there's two ways of getting home from that direction, just so you guys know. There's the 401, which is free, but it's usually annoying right now, especially, like, it's always traffic, terrible, terrible traffic around Toronto. And on top of that right now, Toronto's hosting the Pan American Games, so it's really crazy downtown Toronto. Like, it's just crazy traffic all the time. The other way of getting home, besides side roads, is the 407. Now, 407 is a paid highway. I love to take it. It's expensive, but it's so much of a time saver. Because you just take it, you pay a bit, but I was riding my motorcycle at the time, so motorcycles, you don't have to pay there's a certain extra fee that you have to pay if you have a car, but you don't have to pay the same fee if you have a motorcycle. So that was cool. So I'm on the 407 on my way home. This was Sunday. And all of a sudden, my bike started vibrating. My motorcycle started vibrating like no one's business. I've never felt a vibration like that before. It was really crazy. I thought it was weird. Like, I've gone over construction zones before, and it vibrates as well. But no. And then, so that really spooked me. I'm on the 407. I'm just at the very end of the 407, about to get off it. And then, literally, the second I got off the 407, I was going to pull over. But just before I did, all of a sudden, it started, like, rather than vibrating, it started, like, almost like I was riding my motorcycle on ice. The back tire was slipping out, which made me instantly suspect that something wrong is with the back tire. Usually, that means that maybe you have a flat tire, which really sucks for a motorcyclist on a Sunday where no motorcycle shop is open. And that's exactly what happened. My motorcycle tire went flat on me. Which, to put things in perspective, that tire is only a month and a half old, and I've only put about 500 kilometers on that tire. And now it's flat, but the problem was, riding it, that those couple kilometers when it was vibrating cost me the tire, because the way that it deflated at a weird angle, and it ruined the tire. It burned out the entire side. The right side of the tire was burned to the point where it's not a safe tire to ride anymore. So that was an expensive day because I was in Whitby, Ontario. Now, for those of you who don't know where Whitby, it was about 80 kilometers away, so 50 miles away from my house in Peterborough. And yeah, so I had to get towed because on a on a Sunday, there weren't any motorcycle shops open. So I got the motorcycle towed from Whitby to here, and it cost like $400. It was really expensive, but I had to do it. So, yeah, next time I'm going to get CAA, the Canadian equivalent of AAA, because they'll cover in that case. Learned my lesson. Yeah. So now I'm just going to keep doing, I'll do some lead belcher on Mr. Librarian here first, before going to the non-oil shade. Hopefully I have non-oil. I think I do. A little bit left. Alright, good. So that was really expensive, and then I had to get the tire taken care of, and I have to get a new tire again. And that's going to cost me another couple hundred, like a few $100. So, life is expensive. You know, I had a bunch of work done on my motorcycle in late May, so having to do even more again, kind of annoying, but that's what happens with cars and motorcycles sometimes, is that you just don't have good luck and you have to pay through the teeth. So that sucks. Not much else has happened this week. I've been home mostly because my motorcycle's now in the shop. They had to order a tire in, so it hasn't come in yet. Or it should have come in maybe today, but I'll probably get back next week. The motorcycle shop that I took it to is kind of slow. They're not the fastest shop, but it's okay. I just hope that they do things correctly. I don't think it was negligence on their part. I think it was just a flat tire. Probably just there's the revving guy, motorcycle guy. I think it's just I must have run over a spike or something, or something that popped the tire. Yeah. What else happened over this last week? I got to play a game with Mike Groves. He came over and we did a battle report. It'll be up eventually. I'm gonna hold my battle reports until the end of, I think I'm gonna hold them off until the end of face off. Because it's only a couple more weeks of face-off, and then I'll start printing battle reports out again. Yeah, that would make sense. And so we had a great battle report. We filmed Orcs versus Imperial Fists. It's a lot of fun. Imperial Fists are fun. You know, Marines, they're not the most interesting faction, to be honest, because they're vanilla, right? But they're not that bad at all. I'm really enjoying playing them. I've been trying out a different list each time. And this one, I ran the triple librarian conclave one. And it was a lot of fun. It was powerful. Three librarians. And it was really good. Pretty effective because it makes it easier to cast. Like, I was casting psychic powers on two ups. That was really fun. And plus against orcs. Like, orcs have nothing really to deny psychic powers anyway. So the psychic powers were pretty much, you know, good. And it was a fun game. Maelstrom of War ended up being Cloak and Shadows. So, I'm not going to ruin who won, wins or anything, but it was a good game. I always had a great time playing against Mike. Or with Mike. He's a good guy who likes people. Yeah, and we're probably going to be playing together for another tournament coming up, providing I'm available, which I think I am, so we should be good. But it's a big tournament. It's a devil's tournament called War Masters in September, I think. And that'll be fun. We'll probably play double orcs again, just because we're hilarious. I don't think we can win this time, but it'll still be fun. Maybe we'll win best sports. Yeah. That'd be kind of good. So, yeah, it's going to be a fun tournament. I'm looking forward to it. That'll be good. What else? Gen Con is in 3 weeks. It's hard to believe how fast this... Oop, there he goes. It's hard to believe how fast this summer's been going. That's what happens, you know? As I said, every time I sit down and do a painting with Jay, I'm like, wow, the week's gone by fast. And then before you know it, another painting with Jay. Just how it happens, you know? Yeah, that's life. It goes by so fast these days. This guy, I'm really not that far on. My librarian and Terminator armor, so right now it's kind of fun just figuring out what will be Metallics. But, then maybe I'll work on Reds after them. And maybe these. Yeah. Yeah, I have a bunch of other librarians as well that I was going to save up and do. I'm going to do a Tigerius tutorial in the warp, probably. And that'll be good. He is a lot of fun. So. Yeah. That'll be good. So I've tried a few different detachments so far. What have I tried? The Terminator detachment. I've tried Terminators with the Librarians. I've tried the Land Raider detachment, which was really powerful, but really not the most interesting, because it's just three of, you know, like a 1500 point game in my battle report. Half my points were in Land Raiders. I'm not talking about the points in the land. I just have the points were Land Raiders. So it was not the most, you know, interesting list. But you have these crazy Land Raiders driving around the battlefield that really much cannot be stopped. And once again, it was against orcs. So it was, you know, that guy really likes to rev his motorcycle. Oh, now he just turned it off. There we go. That's approximately all the silver I wanted to do on him. I have another librarian that I've proxied in. I'm just gonna, from now on, my battle reports are gonna be a combination of Dark Angels models and as many, like, I'm gonna try to do whatever army I'm playing will have the most of the, you know, if I'm playing Dark Angels, it'll have primarily Dark Angel models. And if I need to fill in one or two models with Imperial Fists, I will. And, you know, same thing with when I'm playing Imperial Fists, I'll trade as many Imperial Fists models as I can in, but I can substitute them in, you know, with Dark Angel models. Because it's not too hard. You know, they're all space marines. Yeah. I need to buy more non-loyal. I'm working on the commander primarily because I don't already have... No, the captain, sorry. Because I don't have a captain. I have a light, like a Lysander model, but... it'd be nice having this guy finished by the end of this video. I might start focusing more on him with this painting with Jay. Because if I get him done, just another important model that's done. And he's also the last, you know, the quasi-important model I need for my demi company. And I have another demi company I'm going to start off with soon. That way I have two demi companies. You know. And then I just got to buy a bunch of Razorbacks for free. But really don't have money right now. Now I'm saving up money for Gen Con. These conventions are expensive. But it's going to be fun. It's going to be my last big, you know, convention of the year. And it's been a great year for conventions. You know, the two I've done so far, I've had an amazing time at. And I can't wait to go and meet some more viewers and talk with people and meet, you know, hang out with the WGC again. I'm probably going to leave the convention for a day, or most of a day. I got a message today from a subscriber named Josh, and he wants to just hang out for a day, and I might do that. You know, I think that'll be a lot of fun. Just get to know the area, hang out with some locals, play some games probably. Because there's probably going to be no open gaming yet at Gen Con. There may not be. So I would love to film some battle reports with people. So maybe for a day I'll go off and film a battle report with Josh at his local store. And that'll be fun, because it's not like I'll miss that much, right? I'm going to... If I go to Gen Con, Gen Con's Thursday to Sunday, I can easily go away for, you know, a day or even half a day and come back and, you know, catch up where I was at and stuff. But I think it'll be really good. I'm really excited to hang out with him and to film probably a battle report, and it'll be good. I haven't decided yet which army I'm going to bring. Probably Grey Knights. Is my usually go-to travel army. Because I can fit everything in one case really easily. I could do Vanilla Marines. I'm working hard on them. We'll see. Could do Dark Angels. Cool. Dark Angels. I'm gonna play with Dark Angels eventually as well for battle reports. I'm just trying to play with Vanilla Marines a bunch of times because I'm just excited to try out with the Vanilla Marines. But I'll try with Dark Angels as well again. I'm gonna keep playing Dark Angels, as I said. I'm not the happiest with the Codex, but it's all good. I'm not terribly upset. Speaking of people being upset about stuff. Ooh. So I didn't really talk about this last week, because I'm not a big fantasy player. Of course, it's huge in the wargaming community when fantasy gets an update, you know. But apparently people aren't too happy with Age of Sigmar. Apparently it's too big different of a game, and people are just not happy with it. To sum it up. What should I do with him? Black. No, I have to wait for the silver to be done. Kind of out of colors right now. Maybe gold. Yeah. Oh, I can do the... Yeah, I already have a color to work on. People are apparently not too happy with it. Owen. I watched Owen's review, and Owen's review was quite scathing. And he loves fantasy. So... Apparently the rules are just too simplistic, that they remove the anything interesting. So, that's unfortunate. Because I'm not a fantasy player, but I hate to see another game get torched like that. I really do. I don't like that at all. You know, it's not cool. But it apparently is kind of the most people's opinion. Right now I'm just painting with Shapti Bone over some parts that need it. You know, books, scrolls. Oops. And then when I do the silver, it'll fix that. Apparently people are just not happy with it. I didn't do a review on it because I'm not a fantasy player. And so I don't typically do fantasy reviews. And I looked at the models are really cool. Like, they're great looking models. You know, that you got to give credit to GW. Once again, great looking models. But unfortunately, just the rules this time aren't amazing. You know? As I said, that was kind of the universal thing. And also, some of the rules are very silly, apparently. Like, you roll a 13 on two dice, you win the game. You get to reroll if you have a better mustache for certain guys than your opponent. I know, it's fun. Like, it's a cool thing to bring to... I love playing for fun. I'm a fun player. But that seems a little silly for a game that is, you know, the foundation of GW... is fantasy. It's where GW started, was with fantasy. I just don't know why I'm thinking that it's just a starter set and just a goofy starter set for fun, and they'll come out with a, you know, ninth edition rule sets soon, and the rules will fill in, you know, the interesting, like, all the problems, I'm hoping. But people aren't happy. A lot of long-term fantasy players are just going to play 8th. This kind of reminds me of a little bit of back in the day with D&D, right? When they... 3.5 is kind of the version people like to go back to. Because when 4 came out, people were like, you don't like this anymore. So let's keep playing 3.5. And that's the thing. People have the power to still do that. And, you know, good for them. Those are my thoughts on Age of Sigmar. You know, nothing too crazy. I don't have much of a thought because I'm not a fantasy player, but it's unfortunate that if they did that to the game, you know, because it seems like a way, I don't know, maybe it's not as fun. I've only played maybe a handful, 6 or 7 games of fantasy at most, and they're all 8th edition. With Bretonians, and they're fun, but this new edition, I don't know. Obviously, I've not played it, so I just don't want to comment that much on it. You know, it's not. I just, if I don't know too much about it, I'm not going to go crazy and keep talking about a subject. But the models look awesome. That's why I gotta say the models look very cool. Plus, they really do look very close to 40K now. It's starting to get to the point where they're maybe blending the areas. Because those Chaos guys look really close to... Like, one of them looks exactly like a Hellbrute. The Chaos guys are starting to look like Khorne Berserkers. And then the other dudes, I don't know what they're called, unfortunately. But, they look very much like almost old Blood Angels. So it's very cool that they're in this like gray area now of models where it's like they can be used for either fantasy probably or 40K because they look so 40K-ish as well. I think there's going to be some great conversions for people, especially with Blood Angel armies. They're going to have a lot of fun converting up some of these Age of Sigmar guys. I'm going to keep focusing on 40K and a little bit of War Machine Hordes, as I normally do. This week's painting tutorial for the Warp people is actually a Malifaux model. A December Acolyte. He was really cool to paint up, so go check out him in the Warp. It was fun. That Warp preview week was good. I got to do that again sometime because I think people really appreciated it. I think so. What else? Yeah, summer's going by well. Having a good time working, doing commissions, making videos. I promise you I'm going to get back to how to make play to 40K. The next one's just going to be about flamer templates. Just flamer templates in general, then I'll do one on blasts. Then I think I might do assault after that, and then go back and then fit, you know, special rules, vehicles, that kind of stuff, walkers. I think that's all I want to do for him. Is the shade dry? Nope. It's very humid in here right now. So I'm having the problem where it takes a long time for shades to dry. Maybe I should get a dehumidifier. But it's okay. We're 24 minutes in. And my Space Marine Captain is looking good. I already filmed him in a battle report. So... He's, you know, he's quasi-battle report worthy already, but... Alright, there... him. Apparently, there's going to be like the next several months are only going to be dedicated to fantasy for Games Workshop. So there probably won't be any more new codices for a while. Which is okay. You know what? It gives us time to settle and to play and have a good time with all these new codices that we've been getting lately. We've been so spoiled with codices that it's now time for us to have fun, play them, and there'll be a quasi amount of predictability in the game, in the meta, for a little while before yet another one comes out, right? And that's good. You know, I think it'll be good for us to just have fun for a while, and then eventually the new codices will come out back out again. You know, but GW's been going crazy lately. We've gotten like what, six new codices this week. And you know, it's crazy. Tons of new codes, so time for some people to have fun playing 7th. I still love 7th. It's by far, you know, I love 7th way more than 6th. I love Maelstrom. It's my favorite game to play. Maelstrom War is just so much fun. I really do like it. Yeah, like I said, Gen Con's gonna be a lot of fun. Let's put that on. There we go. All done for now. Next color. Gen Con's gonna be a lot of fun. I think it's gonna be a good time. It's gonna be. What color should I do now? Reds. Probably. Maybe I'm a librarian. Shade is still. It's almost dry. And golds and black. Good to go. He's almost done. Not a very complex model. Plus, is with the... that's a part of that I could paint. With the Imperial Fist color scheme, it's not a very complex color scheme. Not a lot of colors. Mostly yellow. That's good. You missed a spot, Adam. Yep. Gotta keep him accountable. What should I do now? Maybe work on the reds while that's drying. Yeah, finish up the reds. And then... this guy. Finish up the reds. I'm gonna switch to working on just the captain. I'm gonna put the librarian in the background because half an hour left. Yeah, and a half an hour spent on him, I could probably finish up the entire model versus bouncing between the two. And the librarian I can easily proxy in right now using a Space Marine librarian or something. So that'll be next week's painting with Jay. Yeah. Besides that, as I said, life just gets expensive and you go with it kind of thing, you know. Things happen. And you must keep going. You just... Right now I'm just working on the reds, doing Evil Sun Scarlet. You know, fixing over them. And you learn, and you keep going. So I learned I should get like CAA or something. And I got some money that I'll have to pay off with some dough and keep going. My wife and I are going to go to this, probably going to go to Saturday's concert. for Peterborough. It's a country artist, so my wife really likes country music, so I think we're going to go and have a good time. She's never been to a concert in Peterborough. She's never been able to go. I always go by myself or with... I've gone with a friend a couple times, but she doesn't get to go usually. She's working, so I'm happy for her. Plus, there's a couple of big country stars coming to... A couple of Canadian country stars that are coming to this area this summer. Chad Brownlee is one of them, and he is this week's. And the other one is Doc Walker, which kind of sounds like Dog Walker. I know, but... Just a quick highlight this up. Well, Shark Week's on. I love Shark Week. Brings me back to my biology days. I love Shark Week. Especially a lot of the science shows that happen for Shark Week. You know, where you learn a lot of cool stuff. I love it. It's such a fun week. This week, today, I watched a show on it's cool. Like, and also you learn little things like Paul Walker, the actor, the unfortunately late actor. He actually did a lot of volunteer work, or maybe not volunteer, maybe he was paid, but he was like a freelance marine biologist when he was alive. I didn't ever know that. So one of the shows called The Spawn of Jaws, which is the whole goal, is following a group of scientists trying to figure out where a great white nesting ground is. And Paul Walker actually helps with a lot of it. I thought it was really cool. You know, you learn a lot about the actor, unfortunately, after he passed. And that was really cool stuff. I didn't know he had such a cool interest in marine biology, you know? That's just really cool stuff. Good job, Paul Walker. Unfortunately, he's late. He's passed on. And, yeah. That was really cool stuff to learn. I learned about hammerheads today and great whites. Yeah, sharks are cool. Years ago, I was debating what field I should go into, marine biology or zoology. Now, most of the time, zoology marine biology is typically a subset of zoology. But the reason why I went into zoology was, number one, I can't swim. And that's a funny fact you may not know about me. Jay can't swim. I can't. So, you know, and then I also watched a lot of shark stuff, and I'm like, you know what? The sharks would win. So I'll stay up on the ground, on ground and study koalas and stuff. And there's, of course, a lot of mammals out there that can kill you, too. Or a lot of animals, you know, terrestrial animals that can kill you. Heck, mosquitoes are one of the number one causes of death in the world. But I can't swim, so I decided, of course, it would be silly of me to go into marine biology if you can't swim. So. That was fun. Jay, no swim. Yeah. True facts. The inside story of Jay. Even on my honeymoon, we went snorkeling, so I just basically like stayed at the top with a life preserver. What's it called? Life jacket. That was a good time. My wife really likes swimming, so if we ever have kids, I want to make sure that they learn. I just never learned. One of those things. To this day, I would love to learn another language, learn how to play an instrument, and learn how to swim one day. So maybe I'll make a list, like a bucket list, and just... Oh, wrong color for that, whatever. I'll fix it after. Good. He's looking good.
But I did highlight the other. Yes, it did.
I'll do Wild Rider Red. And then. Do I have Wild Rider Red out?
I think I did.
Just to finish up the eye, I'll do Wild Rider Red, that dot of white in the top. And then black area, gold area. Good to go. What's the one I'm watching? American Ninja Warrior. What shows? I like summer shows sometimes. Summer shows are just fun. They're not usually too intense of shows. They're usually just fun shows, like game shows. America's Got Talent. You know, American Ninja Warrior. That's what I like about TV shows in the summer. They're just fun. And they hold you over for the summer. I don't watch a lot of TV. I'm watching Shark Week a lot this week, but I don't usually watch that much TV. I'm usually working. You know, I work a lot, but I watch a bit. Nothing too crazy. My wife and I have been watching the TV show Scrubs on Netflix together. I watched Scrubs the first time it aired, but it was really cool, you know, watching it through with her because she hadn't seen most of it. And here's just a white dot in the corner. It was fun, like, watching it again. Season 9, I wasn't a big fan of Season 9 because they kind of redid the show. But Season 8 had a great finale. So I'll do that for String Black. Those ones red. Good. Let's take out the gray liner. Finish up this model. 36 minutes in, so plenty of time. Then I'll have a painted captain for my battle reports. Yeah, Scrubs was a great show. I miss it. Great show. It had a really solid. Oh, I could easily paint the red part there. Had a really solid finale, the way that the show ended the first time. And then they decided to bring the show back to try a new cast with, you know, some of the original cast members. And that was an unfortunate mistake. It wasn't amazing. But, you know, sometimes it's worth trying. But sometimes it sours the TV shows, you know, when it ends on such a solid note, and then the show continues. It's kind of like right now, I'm not going to ruin it, but Breaking Bad, for example, had such a solid, made perfect sense finale. It was a bit predictable, but it happened. You know what? It was predictable because it made sense and was continuous with the story. And it was a great ending, like the show Dexter. But Breaking Bad had such a good finale. Now, they were thinking of bringing back the show. And if they do, there's a way for the show to still happen, right? There's a way for... But the thing is, it ended on such a perfect note, for a lot of people believe, that to bring it back for... would kind of... could ruin the series again. It's risky. You know? Because if it ends on such a perfect note, do you really want to risk bringing it back? And, you know, I don't know. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. And then there's shows like Family Guy, who disappeared and then got really popular through DVD sales. Like, it became almost got a cult following, and then they brought it back. And then, to be honest, the Family Guy is not as good as it once was, but... am I glad it's back? Sometimes, you know. It definitely makes me laugh every now and then. So. But, yeah. It's all about bringing it back at the right time, I guess. But man, American Ninja Warrior, I love that show. Makes me want to go into getting buck shape, you know? Because these people are, it's really cool. It's a cool program. For those of you who don't know American Ninja Warrior, go watch it. It's like a crazy obstacle course competition. Except the winner gets a lot of money, but no one's ever won in the United States. Unless you finish the fourth leg in Mount Midoriyama, the final course, you don't get any money. And no one's ever finished. So each year, these people, like, get better, but at the same time, they up the level of the courses every year. And, yeah, it's just a crazy course. Like, these people are crazy shape. Crazy shape. Mm-hmm. Cool. Look at him. Almost done this guy. Probably a little couple cleanup, like touch-up colors, but this is pretty much a level I like. Maybe I'll do the wires black as well on his face. The thing about Gen Con is, Gen Con really puts, I'm bouncing around between topics today. It puts things into perspective of how small the wargaming niche is within the gaming niche. You know? Because it's such a small niche, like GW gets a tiny booth there. Look at him, he's looking good! There'll be some Caraber Crimson on the gun. Then I'll do some gold. Clean the base up. And keep going. 40 minutes in. He should be basically done by the time this is over. And I got my Capitan. Done. Looking quasi good. This is battle report worthy, you know? He's definitely more than 3-color minimum. It'd be wise to wait a minute and then do the Caraber Crimson, because then the shade will be drying while I'm doing the golds. Yeah, I hope you guys like the finale of Face Off. It was fun. I had a great time filming it. I'm going to do another tournament in the near future, and maybe with some different guys and stuff, remove a couple guys, and it was fun. Stu actually came over and filmed mostly with me. So you guys will notice, like in this week's episode, which aired yesterday, the Wraith Knight versus Goskull Thraka. You clearly see two different sets of dice. Stu is the one throwing with. I should have thrown out. I'm going to mention to him probably in the next intro. But thank you for Stu, if you're out there watching. It was awesome filming with you. And so he filmed the hit rolls, and I filmed the armor save rolls. Yeah, so that was good. Great time. But, we filmed it, and it's cool. So now the entire series has actually been filmed. Oh, I missed an area. So it has been filmed. I know who won. I'm not ruining it. All you'll know is that based on yesterday's episode, it's not either Goskull Thraka or Wraith Knight. One of them is, you know, because one of them gets eliminated. That's all I'm saying. Go check it out. And I will say, I'm not ruining at all who wins, but whoever wins is beatable. I know for a fact that whoever wins, you know, it's just one of those situations that who faces who really matters. It happened a lot of times throughout the tournament that these triangles would happen, you know, where A would kill B, B would kill C, and C could kill A. So it's just literally who faces who. And that would, you know, dictate who moves on. But, yeah, I can't wait. I want to definitely bring back, like, Grok Face Ripa again and see how he does. I really, really enjoyed doing the series. As I said, thank you to Mr. Stu out there. Stu has been awesome. As is Dave. But Stu came over and filmed the back, you know, so give credit where it's due. So if you don't like the result, blame Stu and me. Haha, I'm just kidding. Blame me. Don't take any anger on Stu. We're painters. We're pretty mellow people. Yeah. Happy painting. Let's get some gold on. Now, I'm going to use old gold because I don't want to use rich gold. You guys know I love my liquid gold rain from Vallejo, which is true.
Do I have... Ooh, I didn't think that through.
Yeah, I still have some. I gotta get some more isopropanol. But the reason why I'm going with old gold, because old gold is not as bright, right? It's much browner of a gold versus rich gold, which is a yellowish gold. And if I don't want to do yellow gold over yellow, because then it's too close in color. So I want to add a little contrast and some difference in color. So that's why I'm doing rich gold. Rich gold by liquid gold range. Painting liquid gold. Oh, by painted. I miss that guy. I loved his videos. It was really weird. YouTube, it's cool sometimes. You like certain YouTube channels, you build up just a volume of videos. Like some days I don't put up content and I still make a little bit of money. Not a lot, obviously. But there's certain YouTubers that just haven't made any videos along. Like ByPainted, for example. ByPainted, he made a lot of painting tutorials and they were great quality. Like he did some really good tutorials. As far as tutorial work, he's right up there. Especially if you love airbrushing. You know? But he kind of got mad at GW about a year and a half ago and stopped making tutorials that weren't on his, like he has a paid website that's where his tutorials end up. And B, he stopped making like any battle, like anything 40K other than, you know, he started bashing GW in these vlogs that he does. But he doesn't make any videos anymore. Like he decided to stop making YouTube videos. In fact, he even went as far as to show how much he made. So he opened up his analytics on his you know, in a video, which you don't kind of do. One of the rules of YouTube is that you don't talk about how much you make. Now, obviously, I can go into another topic, PewDiePie, because that hit the news this week. But you're not supposed to talk about how much you make on YouTube. It's just one of the rules. YouTube analytics, the rule of YouTube ad revenue is that you're not supposed to publicly say how much you make. Now, it's always, you know, people estimate about $3 to $5 per 1,000 views, which I'll say is pretty much correct, but I'm not allowed to talk about exactly how much I make. And what's really fascinating about ByPainted is if you go to his YouTube channel, ByPainted still gets tons of subscribers per day. Tons. And people subscribe, like, he gets probably as much, if not more than me, a day. For subscribers. But these subscribers on YouTube, I'm kind of wondering why. As I said, I understand the quality, right? Makes sense. But people, it's like, when I subscribe to a YouTube channel, I like to know that the person is going to make content again. You know? And he isn't. You know, he hasn't made content in about a year and a half. He hasn't made a tutorial. Other than his vlogs where he kind of just GW bashes for 20 minutes. Which people like to watch as well. So I'm just like, alright, so you're, you know, subscribing. That's cool. But just don't kind of expect too much. But that happens sometimes. You know, like there was another YouTuber, Worthy Painting. Now Worthy Painting, they made amazing paint. Like, they were a commission studio. They were amazing. Their quality of their commissions is just, oh my goodness, amazing. That's all I can say. It was amazing. You know, I'll never offer the same level. Of course, they charged a lot more than I could, actually, for my commissions, because I am nowhere near that, but looks good. Their quality of their work was unbelievable. And eventually, unfortunately, they kind of went bankrupt. Or they closed, right? They closed their studio, and they closed their studio. The reason why I'm just continuing going is I just mixed this batch of old gold, and I don't want it to go to waste, so I'm going to paint some gold areas on my librarian while the areas are drying on my captain. Right, and to this day, sometimes they still get tons of views and tons of subscribers. It's just like, cool. I don't know. Teach his own.
as I said, it's just kind of wacky in my mind when it's not that they don't deserve the subscribers, but they're not making content, and they will never make content again. So why do people subscribe? Kind of baffles my brain. But it's one of those times that you'll subscribe and then you'll just never get, you know, you'll just never see a new video posted. Just funny. There's a fly in my workshop. Yep. These librarians are really complicated models. That's cool. I mean, they're really nice, but red. It's gonna be a lot of red. Okay. Whoop. There he goes again. I get those cool holders from Austin from Brush for Hire. Ant-Man comes out soon. I want to go see it. Now, the story is very different from... I hope that they do Ant-Man well, because they've already had to twist around a lot of the Marvel Universe has been moved around to, you know, for convenience purposes. But, like, Ant-Man, I'm pretty certain in the original comics and in the series, the video series, Ant-Man was one actually created... Ultron. It wasn't Iron Man. Ant-Man is a scientist. And then he had a little assistant who was cute, and she did her own stuff as well. And then, I hope Paul Rudd does a good job. I think it'll be interesting seeing him. Evangeline Lilly. She's cool, too. She's Canadian. Yeah. Canada Day was the other day as well. Saw some fireworks. I don't know if Canada was before or after the last video. Might have been before. Yesterday was my anniversary with my wife, just our dating anniversary. It wasn't like our marriage anniversary, but we celebrate a little bit. I brought her flowers and stuff to surprise her. Because, yeah. I'm not the most romantic person, I'll admit it, but I always like to do an occasional romantic gesture. Look at him! He is almost done. I'm going to clean up a couple of the yellows. I'm going to just keep it like that. He looks pretty aged and worn out. I think this is battle report worthy. You know? He looks good. So let's do the base. Get him done. And then, we're 53 minutes. He's done. So you'll see him in a battle report when I start putting up the battle reports again after face off. But he won't be painted in the first one, but he'll be painted probably in the second one. Next time I film with him, he's gonna be all nice and painted and ready for battle reports, and that's good. And then next week my painting tutorial is probably gonna be a chaplain. I'm gonna paint a chaplain for my demi company, and I'd love to do a chaplain painting tutorial. So, then I'll have a chaplain, a captain, Lysander, two librarians done, that other librarian has been started, so that's a good amount of HQ so far. Who else? Then I'll probably work on a demi company again, maybe, I don't know.
have to figure out what I want to do again. I start the second demi company, which I do have the models for anyway, and then yeah, I don't know. Eventually I'll pick up some scouts. I want to buy a couple more squads of scouts. Paint up one as Dark Angels, and paint up two as Imperial Fists, and then use them all together in battle reports and stuff. But what else have I been watching? Oh, I watched through Netflix as well recently. A great show. If you have ever had the chance to watch it, The Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt. It is a hilarious show. I really loved it. Tina Fey's behind it, and it was really funny. Just the comedy is just really just funny. It's really goofy humor, but it was really funny. It's about a girl named Kimmy Schmidt, of course, and Kimmy was kind of captured and imprisoned in a bunker for years by a leader of a cult. And then she's released, and then it's her dealing with... It's kind of... It has a lot of parallels to me that to the old movie Blast from the Past with Brendan Fraser. Because it's one of those ones where it's, you know, the main character doesn't necessarily... It's kind of fish out of water because the main character doesn't necessarily know how to deal with the real world around it. It makes a lot of goofy life choices and stuff. But really funny. I recommend that show. The... Well, that's drying. We'll quickly touch up the gun, and I'll call it. It's been a good week, good day. You know, we've gotten. This is very therapeutic. You know, I talk about my issues, my life. Y'all listen. I must thank you all for painting with me. You know, you're my kind of my psychiatrists. I love this series. This is by far. I know a lot of people think tell me it's actually their favorite series for me to film. It's for me to make. It's one of my favorite series to film, because I just get work done, I talk. As I said, it's very therapeutic. There we go. Look at my captain. Oh, captain, my captain. And he's all done. I'm just going to do a quick basing scheme on him. But he'll be ready to go for future battle reports, and he's going to go kick butt on the battlefield. And let's end it. Now, so as always, thank you so much for painting along with me. I really hope you had a great time, got some work done too. My captain's done, and that's great. You know, another couple hundred points on the battlefield, ready for Imperial Fists. Nothing wrong with that. So I really hope you enjoyed stuff. I hope your weeks are going a little bit better and not as expensive as mine is. And remember, if you want to paint, buy your own Jade Knight Army shirt, go check out miniwargamerj.spreadshirt.com, because the shirts are pretty fun. People keep buying them and telling me how much they love them, so good stuff there. And yeah, so thank you as always for painting along with me, and stay tuned for next week, which I'm just going to keep doing painting with Jace, because I love the series, I love painting, and you love it. We all get work done, everyone wins. So as always, thank you very much for watching. Till next time, this is Jay saying happy painting with Jay.